ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Denzel Curry.
Denzel Curry.
Denzel Curry.
I'm supposed to call him Zeltron, but also known as Denzel Curry.
Zeltron out the barrio, cold as Ontario. These niggas hysterical, I'm historical.
He's probably one of the best rappers I've seen in real life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And all this has been just the beginning.
I've just seen so many like scenes go by, and then he always kind of seems like he's the last one left that's still doing his thing out of those scenes.
Denzel Curry is an artist that has been in the game since 2011 and has both lived and thrived through multiple hip-hop eras. From his early days with Raider Clan, his viral hit Ultimate and the legendary 2016 Cypher, to his critically acclaimed Taboo and his most recent release Melt My Eyes, See Your Future, Denzel Curry has had a lengthy and successful career. Struggling with many hardships throughout his life, Denzel Curry has persevered with a smile on his face and a positive attitude, preaching to the youth to keep on walking.
Yo, 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 you already know who it is. It's your boy, Denzel Aquarius Killer Curry from that Raider Clan, you feel me? Also known as Raven Miyagi. Y'all stay tuned. If I do this freestyle shit, you ain't ready.
Denzel Raydon Curry, born on February 16th of 1995, grew up in Carroll City, Florida, which was also referred to as the Zoo. He grew up with three older brothers, one of which would start rapping under the name Soulja Mook. As a kid, he loved drawing and music. He would get into poetry and eventually rap battles in school. He didn't start recording though until 2010 when he was 15 years old.
Growing up in Carroll City, man, like, you know, I'm not really a hood nigga. Well, I'm a hood nigga, of course, right? But I'm not a street dude.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? Like, my brother's been in the streets.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't have to be in the streets. Yeah. So I went to Crestview, and that's, you know, I wasn't into rapping or nothing like that. My real passion was drawing. And then, you know, I got into rapping at sixth grade, and then I learned how to rap through a homie of mine. So he taught me how to rap, because I would battle him every day and lose. No, I would always lose and shit, but I was getting good. It even got to a point where we would battle so much. Like, remember MySpace, right?
Of course.
Me and him would always be on MySpace. I was like, battle, nigga. Like, we wasn't freestyling, we was keystyling. We was like, battle, nigga. Like, let's go.
Yeah, what it is, It's 2010, and I was born in 1995. See, my dog Halo, he was born in 94, so I'm just gonna do what we do till I go, you feel me?
The first two Denzel songs on the internet are from 2010, and they're called 95 Till I Die, 94 Till I Go, and All I Know, both of which are featuring Halo Kid. When Denzel was 16, he dropped his first ever mixtape on January 16th of 2011, and it was called Curry Was Here. At the time, he was going under the name PH Curry. The mixtape was since deleted until it resurfaced in 2021, shocking fans and even Denzel himself. It even featured an amazing tribute to Kid Cudi, one of Denzel's favorite artists.
Day and night.
What?
Or afternoon, what? I'm always on my grind.
What?
I look what? Up, I'm always singing blue.
What?
Cause all the lies I heard, there's nothing true.
In 2011, Denzel started frequently recording at the Zoo Mansion, which was a house owned by Metro Zoo, which was a collective based out of Carroll City, consisting of members Lofty 305, Ruben Slick, Freebase, and Postronaut, artists and producers he's worked with many times.
I had a desk here, and like the desktop, everything, and they had like a big ass booth right in this little corner right here.
This shit used to be mad graffitied out now.
Mad
like a typical
out.
Teenage room, dog.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
oh no, my
God,
we
was writing on the ceiling and shit. I remember on this wall, it had rules. No shoes, no fuck niggas.
Wait, fuck that bitch and fuck a other man. Curry the killer nigga, use my other hand. What the fuck's up? Got a big bitch. I don't give a fuck, nigga, trying to get rich. Give me your money, give me your cheese. Goddamn, I'm juvenile from 100 degrees. What the fuck is up, nigga? Got Mr. B. Motherfuckers catching A's. Easy E.
And my homie Mike DC, and what my homie who was Mike DC at the time, he had Perp's number, and he was like, yo, we're gonna do a song with this guy, bro, and this guy's gonna fucking, yo, this shit's gonna be awesome. And I'm just like, shit, I don't even know who the nigga is. You feel me? But like, I heard his song, which was Suck a Nigga Dick for 2011, and then I called him, and he was actually here in New York with Rocky at that time. And that's when, you know, Blackland Radio and then Live Love ASAP, that was around that time where it came out. And then I called him. He was watching a game with, I think the Dolphins was playing. And I was like, yo, can I be able to join Raider Clan? And he was like, oh, yeah, for sure. Because, like, I drew a picture for him and shit.
Yeah.
And then I was like, I rap too, you feel me? So, and he was just like, all right. And then I was like, I won't let you down. Then I dropped King Remember It. That was, like, the first mixtape I ever dropped.
Da-dee-da. Oop-dee-oop. Oop-dee-woop.
Bum-bum-bum.
My niggas round here make you do the chicken noodle soup.
On September 24th of 2011, Denzel released his EP King Remembered Underground Tape 1991 through 1995 on DatPiff and YouTube. There was even a song where the beat sampled the X-Files, and it was pretty hard. He released it under his alter ego Aquarius Killa. Denzel has multiple alter egos, and he explains it like this.
Each album I do, I introduce like a new part of me in my life.
Right.
Like when I did my mixtapes, I did Aquarius Killa for my first mixtape, did Raven Miyagi for my second mixtape. Third mixtape was just Denzel, period. Then I did, when I did Nostalgia, I introduced Denny Cascade. I did 3-2 Zell, Planet Shrooms. I introduced Ultimate Denzel Curry. Ultimate Denzel Curry took over and did the Imperial tape. And then after Imperial, it was going from Ultimate Denzel Curry. That's why you're hearing certain songs in there. And then the last song ends up being Zeltron 6 Billion, which is the character that pretty much got every bit and piece of the personalities I created from back in the day going into Taboo. But all of that is just Denzel. That's all just me.
Right.
Then on January 12th of 2012, Denzel dropped his second mixtape, King of the Mischievous South Volume 1, Underground Tape 1996, which featured multiple artists from Metro Zoo and Raider Clan. You could tell that Denzel had potential, but he was lacking resources at the time, with most of the songs being held back by the production quality. Denzel Curry about to rip this bitch with that Raider slang. I come in this bitch, ready to attack. Smack a bitch, chicken head, but I ain't no project.
God damn, nigga, where your foot? Hey, nigga, you filming this shit?
I'm sorry.
Get your ass on the floor, nigga. What you doing with this motherfucking camera, nigga? Hey, nigga, who's your grandma, nigga? Nigga trying to run, nigga. Get his ass, nigga.
Bum, bum, bum. Bap, bap, bum. Bum, bum, bum.
Thump, thump, thump.
Oh, I feel you. You know what I'm saying? What the fuck did you just say?
Around this time, Denzel was hanging out with Puya and Fat Nick, so that was a connection that was built very early on in his career. The same day that this video came out, on May 13th of 2012, so would Denzel's third mixtape, Strictly For My Raiders, which was partially a way of paying homage to Tupac. It featured many artists from Metro Zoo, Xavier Wolf, and more. It was also a tribute to Trayvon Martin, who Denzel went to school with, and he knew some of his family members.
I made three mixtapes with Raider Clan. You know what I'm saying? The first one was called King Remember. The second one was called King of the Mischievous South. And the third one was called Strictly For My Raiders. And the only reason I did that one is because when Trayvon Martin got killed, that shit gave me nightmares of that shit ever happening to people like me. Because he came from Kara City. The same way. He went to Kara City, then he went to Croc.
After Strictly For My Raiders, Denzel decided it was best to start working on an album to show everyone that he was more than just a mixtape rapper.
Right now we're working on his first official project or official album. But this one, we're taking our time, you know, we're in the real studio this time. You know, actually taking the time to sit down and write, because, you know, sometimes he freestyles and whatnot. So this is, you could say, kind of like his first album, in a sense. I mean, he's been able to build a fan base off of just putting out, like, three lo-fi tapes and doing a couple features here and there and whatnot. So I know once he gives them his full potential and shows the world his full potential, then from there, the sky's the limit.
I don't know if y'all knew, but like during the like process of the album, I left the Clan.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
But it wasn't on no, you know what I'm saying, no green shit. I'm still cool with them. Yeah. You know what I mean? But it was just like, okay, after I dropped the album, it just showed everybody and their mama that I could stand on my own too and do my own thing without like
the relying on the name of Raider Clan to kind of help you out
Yeah.
So like,
I mean, even though I've been there, those are my roots, and I'm never going to forget that.
Yeah.
But dropping the album just showed like I could do it myself.
Absolutely.
And I could
yeah.
also be a leader as well.
I'm the bullet that killed Kennedy. Enemy. DITC. Darker symphony. Necro. Fuck around and let the tech blow. Red pin to his knock and make it look like techno. I told you I don't even want to be the best hoe. I'm the third with Tourette's, making motherfuckers John Doe.
Denzel was working on the album as a senior in high school and dropped it when he was 18. He drew the covers for both of the singles off the album. He also drew the album cover as well. And he finally dropped the album on September 3rd of 2013.
Dark and Violent. That's one of my favorite songs ever. That's a story, bro. See, some other little
first,
shit.
The first half of Dark and Violent, which was created by Poshnot, the first half, you know what I'm saying, which is the dark side.
Mm-hmm.
And I told him, like, yo, let's make this into a story because it's Dark and Violent. It's coming from the dark side, and now let's get to the violent side, which could cause it to be a whole story related to the first side. You know what I'm saying?
Good.
But it's just a tale of trials and tribulations and what actually goes down in modern day society in the land, you know?
Denzel describes this album as him talking about what he saw growing up, so it's about nostalgia. He says he saw a lot growing up, and he admits his cousin died when he was 13, and another one of his friends was also killed across the street from his aunt's house. Denzel says that he's been through a lot and had to deal with a lot of death. It's a very real album that discusses his life growing up. It was also a huge step in the right direction in terms of production quality, and it had some really good songs on it.
A final farewell. The family of a South Florida man tased by police laid him to rest today. 27-year-old Trayon Johnson died last month. This after witnesses say police used physical force, pepper spray, and a taser to restrain him during an altercation.
This is the man that's known in the underground world of backyard brawling.
In fact, he was starring in a documentary about the amateur fistfights.
As they prepare to bury a son and a brother, Trayon Johnson's loved ones continue to wait for answers about exactly how he lost his life.
Leo police tased my brother, and then they couldn't be able to save him in the hospital. It pierced his bowels, and his bowels poisoned his body, and he ended up dying of cardiac arrest, and that's how he died.
If my child wasn't tased, would he be living today? Nobody have a picture perfect life, and I know they're gonna try to paint this ugly picture of my son, but I can care less.
But I don't think it's fair that what happened to him, and like my family, my wife, and my cousin here, we want closure.
Trayon Johnson was Denzel's older brother, who had been a big influence on him growing up, just like any big brother would be. Trayon, also known as Tree, was an aspiring fighter who was featured in the documentary on backyard brawls called Dogfight. This devastating loss would leave a large impact on Denzel's future, and would be a topic referenced in multiple songs going forward. The music video for the song Ricky, named after his father, was a beautiful reference to his late brother's backyard brawling days, and even featured the same ring announcer, Dada 5000.
. 2014 was like the most depressive year I ever had in my life.
Mm-hmm.
Most depressive. Any other year, most depressive.
How did you crawl out of it?
I immediately just went on tour after that.
My man.
Just after, I couldn't even grieve or nothing.
Shortly after his brother's death, he released his song Power with Mike Deese on March 28th of 2014, which has a verse that is actually probably familiar to most people.
Rest in power, it's all about power. Squeeze two levers together and really all you have is down, please. Niggas will smoke your ass and have the juice. Running around in an all black coupe, double up engine, I'm ready to shoot. Shit, lucky you bucking and dodging and dropping them. Lucky you bucking and dodging and dropping them. 48 houses and cigarette butts.
Throughout 2014, he was on tour with De Niro Ferrar in Canada and the United States, and he also performed at South by Southwest. While he was on tour, he was working on his upcoming double EP, Planet Shrooms and 32 Zell.
We're at the end in Brooklyn, just doing finishing touches for 32 Zell and Planet Shrooms. The album, Denzel's pretty much trying to appease both his fans. He's trying to appease the new ones and his old ones. A lot of them are used to his underground sound, like having that dirty grittiness, and he wants to cater to them, as well as trying to push the like commercial sound for his newer fans. So we're trying to find a good balance between both sides, so we decided to do like a double EP just to cater to both of them.
How do we all say go to it? Anybody fell with Vegeta? Well, let's get this spirit bomb going. Everybody put your hands up.
Basically, my team is C9. ULT is a lifestyle. It's not a group. It's not a gang. It's not none of that shit. Mm-hmm. It's a fucking lifestyle that anybody can rep. C9 is a group, and who's part of C9 is myself, JK the Reaper, Yoshi Tompkins, S. Braddy, and Ronnie J. Listen Up, you feel me? And don't forget my dog Postronaut, which is in the back right there, you know what I mean? That's my gang, and then we're affiliated with other people that helped me compose my albums, which also include Posh Gang and 12lin, because those are my homies as well, and Young Simi, you feel me? That's my homie. Yeah. And like, these are the people I work with on a daily basis.
Denzel started repping a loose collective called C9 around this time after leaving Raider Clan. He even has the group's logo tatted on his stomach. Flirting with death seems like the biggest infidelity. Darkened the skin on the ebony and the biggest city, the referee has taken out one of my niggas. Tierra Grant was the name. Both shot up in the car and those ended up slain.
Tierra was my best friend. Like, no, not my best friend, but she was like a good friend of mine.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? I've known her since middle school and shit. And when I found out she got killed, you feel me, my heart just dropped. I went to her wake, you know what I'm saying, a day before I had to go to New York. I couldn't even go to the funeral.
Yeah.
But, like, when I was, like, working on Planet Shrooms and shit, you know, me and Freebase made a whole beat pack with raps on it. And most of those songs I dedicated to Tierra and shit. And that's why Tierra is, like, mainly Planet Shrooms. And 3-2 Zell is my brother.
On June 9th of 2015, Denzel released the double EP 32 Zell and Planet Shrooms, dedicating 32 Zell to his brother who had passed while he was working on the project, and Planet Shrooms to his friend Tierra, who had also unfortunately passed. Both projects received mixed reviews. However, 32 Zell included Denzel Curry's most viral song to this date, and that song is called Ultimate. Planet Shrooms was more of a throwback to his mixtape era, whereas 32 Zell was more of a clean cut album. One of the best songs off 32 Zell being Ice Age. Jeez, boss. Make her drink the cum sauce. Bring her ass to my world, but this might have an ass loss. By this time, Denzel had already amassed quite the fan base. Songs like Threats and Ultimate had given him quite a bit of exposure, but it would be nothing compared to the next year to come.
A lot of people like didn't like 32 Zell Planet Shrooms. When I was 19, 20, I was just making shit like Ice Age and Lord Vader Kush and stuff like that in my psychedelic phases, and then when I was working on Imperial, a seriousness that I had on Nostalgic came back, but it was way, way more serious than it was on Nostalgic, because it was like half influence, half this. But Imperial was like, this is me and I'm here to stay.
. 2016 was a busy year for Denzel. He released his sophomore album Imperial on March 9th of 2016, but it was later re-released. This album was his best body of work to date, and songs like This Life and ULT would garner him a lot more attention. This was the year that he also became an XXL freshman.
Because I dropped Imperial for free. Initially, I dropped it for free with two original tracks on it, you know what I'm saying? That got changed later on when we re-released it.
When Raider Clan got blackballed and everything, and I separated myself and did what I had to do. And I was telling them, like, telling my booking agent, like, most of the guys that was in Raider Clan at that time aren't bad people. They aren't, you know what I'm saying? And I was really vouching for them at that point. And then that's when Perp turned on me after I squashed the beef with ASAP at South by Southwest.
So you were really like the vocal force to really like hash it all out and really just end it.
Like, pretty much, cause I knew I was gonna end up seeing these guys. And I met Rocky for the first time last year.
We had this thing called the ULT house, and not just X lived there. Ronnie J lived there with me. 12lin, JK the Reaper, Posh God, Postronaut. When me and my girl broke up, I went crazy. I went crazy for a while, and then I painted my whole room, and then I drew all over the walls and shit. All my furniture and all that equipment just started coming in that day in my laptop, and we built the studio in my closet, and then I had like a carpet and I had a little couch, and I started hanging out with my artwork and stuff, and then I just started working from there on everything that was made on Imperial. So X pulls up in a big ass minivan, like, I'm like, what the fuck is going on? So he pulls up, Yoshi at the house, Ronnie at the house, all the homies at the house, 12lin at the house, everybody. And
Ski's there. Ski pulled up with him. And then we just got to the point like, yo, we want y'all to be in ULT, da-da-da-da, this, that, and the third. And then we went to the room and then started making shit. Like Yoshi and X were the first ones to make a song in my room. And it was called Hit the Dirt.
Yo, let's film this music video too. Fuck it. That was the video. That was the video.
So random! After that song, we went outside to play football. Like, we played football and shit.
Got it.
Okay. She bombing niggas on camera.
X versus Marvelous.
Here we go.
Yeah, here's the D-man.
Then we came back. As soon as it came back, we made Space Ghost Pussy. And that's when we went against Perk.
Cause bitch, I'm a Raider clan killer. UIT nigga, smoke all the Perk. X start the dealer. You don't fuck, nigga. I can fuck with your waist blank pillow. Pussy nigga, killer.
When I was creating this album, it was literally what happened from 2016, 2017, what happened in 2018. Mm-hmm. And that whole process of making this album was like finding who Denzel Curry was, you know what I'm saying? I had to move out my crib and shit, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? I had to go back to my parents' house, and like I went back to my dad's spot to regroup and rethink everything what I was doing. Like I was dealing with like breakups, I was dealing with like people not fucking with me because like whatever. I looked at everything, I was like, if I don't do something now, I'm gonna get into something, some bullshit. And I was like, I'm moving to Cali. I need to get away. And that was like majority of
2017.
Denzel was gearing up to release yet another album that would be a huge artistic evolution for him, and it was called Taboo. Taboo was built out of a lot of anger and passion. He said things like Ultimate becoming such a meme, his peers surpassing him, and things like that were really what fueled this album. But first, he had to bridge the gap.
I wanted him to bridge the gap between Imperial, which was the last album I did before the EP, and Taboo, so you won't hear the same shit from Imperial on Taboo. You get me? So I had to bridge the gap between it, and that's what 13 was, just the gap between Imperial and Taboo.
He released the album on July 27th of 2018, and it was his most well-received album so far. He covered some pretty heavy and personal topics throughout the album.
Nah, I released it in three acts so you could know what part you're in. Mm-hmm. So when I released the first part, even though I touched on dark subjects, it was still a light. Yeah. You know, there's light at the end of the tunnel. See, look, gray part represents the reality of everything. And I put it to a sense like, okay, you talk about money and happiness. And they was like, you know the term, you can't buy happiness?
Yeah.
I put the gray part like reality check or reality needs a check. The thing with the dark area was like, when I was in that dark place, and I started with the dark part first, mm-hmm. it was basically like just a barrage of emotions that I was having.
I knew you wasn't normal ever since the age of 9. I heard you were molested when you hit the age of 5. So innocence, I sensed that all your innocence had died. You swallowing all of your pride, won't let anybody get inside.
I'm gonna be real, I did get molested when I was young. You feel emasculated. Mm-hmm. Like, that's why most men don't come out and say, like, that happened to them.
Denzel continued his theme of talking about personal struggles and grievances on this album, but in a very creative way. Right before the album's release, he suffered again another loss of a friend.
Where were you when you got the news about X, though?
I was in Miami when it happened. I get the, my brother texted me. He was like, bro, he gone. And that was it. And that shit made me break down and cry. It hit me because this is somebody I made music with, somebody I would talk to, somebody that I hung out with, you know what I'm saying?
I'm
So I remember when I was working on Taboo, and after Taboo was finished, I kept working because I was like, the grind don't stop, and I don't want to lose that momentum. Bro, we was just in the studio, and we was like, yo, let's make some hard shit. And they was like, what's the next move? Let's just make some hard shit. That was it. And we just went into the studio and just did just that. Just made some hard shit. And then just the subject matter, all that came about. I mean, I freestyled the whole thing. It was just like stuff I was freestyling always related back to what I was doing back when I was living in Miami. Because I don't live there no more.
On May 31st of 2019, not even a full year after the release of Taboo, Denzel released his next album called Zoo. He said this album was mostly for fun and to have some music to turn up to. This album pays homage to his hometown, hence the name and the lyrical contents. Denzel also revealed how he likes to connect his albums.
So the way I treat my albums, I mean, most people treat them like diary entries, chapters to your life. Me, I treat mine like films.
He likes to sprinkle in little references, both lyrically and sonically, that refer to different albums, songs, and instances in his life.
That's how I treat my albums.
Wow.
That's why I sprinkle certain things I say in my albums. Like, you might hear something from Nostalgic on this one. You might hear something from King Remembered on this one. Or you might hear something from this on this one. That's how I do my albums. My daddy said, trust no man.
The largest track off of the album, called Ricky, is named after his father and is all about his life living back at home.
My dad is one of the major influences on my life, you know?
Right.
Like, I stayed with him when my mom left. Like, I stayed with my dad, and I stayed with him for the remainder of my life.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just like, man, whatever you want to do, man, chase your dreams, man. Like,
That's
he
dope.
Helped me chase my dreams, you know? I just wanted to draw and shit. Like, that was my whole thing. My mom put me in piano classes when I was, like, real young. And my mom was like, no, this might help you out. And I was like, I don't want to do this. I just want to draw. That's it. I want to draw.
You were one of those kids.
My dad put me
right?
in art yeah. school.
Uh-huh.
And then I realized how much I hated art school.
Oh, my God.
And then I got kicked out of art school.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
man.
So it was like a chain reaction. And then when I started doing music and started getting recognized for it, I was like, damn.
I do like this.
You know, my mom was probably right.
This year, Denzel also sustained another devastating loss when he lost his dreads. He then became bald. Switch my look, I got on hook, they call me young, heart throb, I am bald!
Blood in, blood out.
On January 6th of 2020, Denzel tweeted out a YouTube link to a mixtape called Blood In, Blood Out. It was teased back in 2018 and was full of throwaways from Imperial, Taboo, and Zoo, all mixed together with transitions and the same gritty style that is reminiscent of his early mixtape days. Other than a brief YouTube description though, Denzel hasn't really said anything about this mixtape, but it is a very good project. It features artists like Ghostmane, Zillikami, Xavier Wolf, and more.
Did you take the double X? I told you I needed the bigger one. This shit is dumb tight on
well,
my head.
Well, nigga, you the one who gave me this motherfucker then. Big head ass. All
right, come here. All right, you ready?
I guess, nigga.
Come on.
Then Denzel Curry and Kenny Beats released an EP called Unlocked on February 7th of 2020 that was accompanied with a full-length video, creating a story of Denzel and Kenny going into Kenny's computer to find the missing files. Each song had an animation and it was very artistic. Then Denzel and Kenny dropped Unlocked 1.5 about a year later, which was a new version of Unlocked with instrumentals and features from Smino, Joey Badass, Benny the Butcher, and Kenny Mason.
Denzel had come to my studio, the cave, and we had filmed a little thing that day. And then later in the day, I was like, let's stick around, let's work on some stuff. And that was the first beat, first song we made. And I think when we made Layup, we knew we were onto something different, kind of. Yeah, like we were just onto a different wave. When we looked at the project in my iTunes on the last day, it looked all kinds of messed up with weird hyphens and weird underscores and this and that. And we were like, let's just
keep it like that.
Let's just make it feel how it feels.
When we created the project, it was like, all right, we created it so fast and got it mixed and mastered so fast. We was like, yo, we just got time to plan.
Uh-huh.
That was it. We was like, yeah, we gonna link it online. You feel me? It's gonna be me and him. And we just gonna argue on Twitter, da-da-da, this, that, a third. And then he was the one who came up with the idea of like keeping the track listing the way it was.
Where's the fucking files, Kenny?
Bro, come
Where
on.
Where's the files? I bet you was in here, huh? This is how they got it. Puppy photos. Why would you have puppy photos on? Oh!
Whoa, bro, get out of there!
Oh!
That's private.
Bro, what is this?
Bro, that is not for you. That's private. Close that.
Once you melt your eyes, you become aware. Once you become aware of things, you can see the truth within society and see the truth within yourself. So basically, melting away your eyes is melting the perception of what society is and what you used to be, and seeing everything for what it really is. And that's hard to do, because like, even when you melt that perception and see everything what it is, if you know too much, everything gonna seem sad. That's why they say ignorance is bliss.
On March 25th of 2022, Denzel dropped his most recent album, Melt My Eyes, See Your Future. This is his most introspective album to date and covers topics like rekindling drug addictions, struggling with identity, depression, suicidal thoughts, the childhood trauma of being molested, and many more powerful and personal topics. With all the alone time Denzel had in quarantine, it really prompted him to take a look inward.
When nobody's telling you who you are, who are you? Each of those projects that I had was like one emotion. Like Imperial, I was angry. With Taboo, I was sad. Mm-hmm. With Zoo, I was homesick. With this one, it was just like self-discovery. Flaws and everything. Yeah. Shit I gotta work on. Mm-hmm. This album isn't being like, oh, I recognize my flaws, now I'm a perfect person. Yeah. It's more like, I recognize my flaws and I'm working through them.
And working towards being being
a better person. I can't be perfect.
Hey, I'm gonna let y'all know right now, we gonna have the best albums of 2022. So
you heard it here first.
What everybody talking about, we gonna have the best shit. Me, him, Jid. Uh-huh.
It is a fact.
Meech.
It is a fact.
Whoever I miss, I'm sorry, but I know I'm gonna get you. No, this is dead ass my cousin.
Really?
This is his cousin.
This album has also been attempted and in the works for almost 4 years now.
It was September 2nd, 2018 at 10:36 a.m. I wrote the first draft of Melt My Eyes.
Wow.
And the genres was acid jazz, trip hop, mm-hmm. R&B, jazz, boom bap, drum and bass, jungle, funk, mm-hmm. neo soul, dance hall, punk, and synth pop.
As we've seen throughout Denzel's life, he has been through a whole lot of hardships and pain, but he has poured his pain into his music to make beautiful art for all of his fans. The latest album is a perfect testament to that. Thanks to Denzel's positive attitude and success, he has shown that despite all of the hardships, you can persevere and keep on walking.